Hello friends, welcome back to Shiji Classes, and in this video I am going to discuss on malignant mesothelioma. First of all, we will discuss the definition. It is a rare malignant tumor of the mesothelial cells. It is a diffuse lesion arising either from the parietal or visceral pleura that spreads widely in the pleural space. The sites are pleural, most commonly, then peritoneum, pericardium, tunica vaginalis and genital tract. In that, it is called the benign adenomatoid tumor. Next, we will discuss the risk factors. First, exposure to asbestos. In the asbestos factory workers, it is commonly seen. It has long latent period of approximately 25 to 45 years. For the asbestos workers, particularly those who are also the smokers, the risk of dying from the lung carcinoma far exceeds from that of developing mesothelioma. Here, asbestos bodies and the plaques are found. Zeolites, radiation, SV40 virus can also be the cause for malignant mesothelioma. Next, the cytogenetic abnormality include the homozygous deletion of CDKN2A or INK4A involving the chromosome 9P, most commonly involved gene. Next, we will discuss the morphology. Grossly, it is a diffuse lesion. It appears as a thick layer of soft, gelatinous, grayish pink tumor. It may extend into the fissures and interlobular septa, a distribution often termed as the pleural rind. Next, we will discuss the microscopy. There are three types of cells seen in the microscopic view. First one is the epitheloid type cell. It is seen in 60% of the individuals. It consists of cuboidal, columnar or flattened cells forming the tubular, glandular or papillary structures resembling adenocarcinoma. The immunohistochemistry stain is positive for keratin proteins, calretinin, WT1 that is Wilms tumor 1, cytokeratin 5-6 and D240. Next, we will see the second type of mesothelioma, that is mesenchymal or sarcomatoid type. It is seen in 20% of the patient. It consists of spindle cells similar in the appearance to a fibrosarcoma. It shows lower expressions of the above mentioned markers and some may be positive only for the keratin. Now we will discuss the clinical course. Average age is 60 years. Problems associated with the malignant mesothelioma are chest pain, cough, dyspnea, fever, and recurrent pulmonary effusions are the more commonly seen. Weight loss and malaise can be seen. The spread can be direct local invasion of the lung, lymphatic spread to the hilar lymph nodes, and hematogenous spreads to the liver, bones, peritoneum, and adrenals. The prognosis of the malignant mesothelioma is poor. Approximately 50% of the patients die within 12 months of diagnosis and few survive longer than 2 years. So how can we diagnose this tumor? We can diagnose it on the chest X-ray. Abnormal thickening of the pleura can be seen. Through CT scan, the stage of the malignant mesothelioma can be determined. MRI, pulmonary function test and blood tests are also useful. In the blood test, high level of fibrillin 3 and SMRPs are present. Pleural fluid cytology can be done. Thoracentesis and needle biopsy are also useful. Endoscopic biopsy can also be done. FISH, it is a hybridization technique and used to detect the cytogenetic abnormalities. The treatment can be extrapleural pneumonectomy, radiation, chemotherapy, immunotherapy and target therapy. At last, we will see the complications. Mesothelioma spread to the peritoneum, pericardium, tunica vaginalis, genital tract, etc. The peritoneal mesotheliomas. They are related to the heavy asbestos exposure in almost 60% of the male's patient. Intestinal involvement frequently leads to the death from the intestinal obstruction and inanition. So here we complete this topic. Thanks for watching my video. If you found it helpful, then please like, share and subscribe.